I have an idea, and I hope you're as excited about it as I am. I want to take you on vacation.
Why?
Well, I thought an adventure might do us some good, give us a chance to have some fun, maybe get reacquainted, even do a little bonding.
What'd you have in mind?
Well, this is not about where I want to go. This is about where you want to go. Dad, I give you the world.
Okay. Well, maybe I'm not as sophisticated as you, but I think I should see America first.
Great! We're Americans. We should see America.
And I want to see it in a Winnebago.
Oh, Winnebago! This is my final word. I'm not going.
Hey, great news! Daphne's coming, too.
And so am I.
Well, you've certainly got this trip well planned, Mr. Crane. Whenever I take a holiday, I'll just grab a fresh pair of knickers and see where the wind takes me.
Niles. Niles.
Dad, we didn't miss anything.
Oh, my God!
We are now on the road less traveled. From now on, there is a new order. We dance to the rhythm of the road.
All right, now, don't worry about anything. Now, there's got to be an access road leading back onto that turnoff. Where is it? Where is it? Oh, it's always in the crack!
So is life, Dad.
Before I take it, you know it's $10 Canadian.
Oh, for a treasured memory like this, what's money?
Okay, one.
Why would she want Canadian dollars?
Two.
Because we're in Canada.
Three.
Ah! We're in Canada?
Yeah, we crossed the border a little while ago. You were taking a nap.
But I can't be in Canada. I'm not allowed to leave the United States.
Why?
Because I don't have my green card yet.
Just sneak her back across the border.
That's called smuggling.
Oh, thanks, Niles. I knew it was something bad guys did. I just didn't know the technical term.
Dad, I can't believe that you, of all people, a former policeman, are actually suggesting that we commit a felony.
Oh, I cross this border plenty. 99 times out of 100, the guards just peek in the door and wave you through. It's no big deal. Come on, let's get out of here.
What if they pull us over?
Well, Daphne's just got to convince them that she's an American.
Bloody right. It beats having me bum bounce back across the pond. Let's give it a bash.
Oh, yes, this is foolproof.
On the off chance a guard asks you a question, can you say anything in an American accent?
Sure.
Okay, what?
You just heard it.
What?
Sure. That's it. That's all I can say. Oh, I need a cup of tea.
Tea? Why don't you just wave a crumpet in the air and start singing God Save the Queen?
Guard pokes his head in here. What did we say he's gonna see?
Four carefree Americans.
I've never been so nervous.
Actually, I don't think there's any need to be. It looks like they're waving everybody through. They're not even asking any questions.
Please, please, please.
Okay, they're waving us through. They're waving us through. They're pulling us over.
Here comes the guard.
I can't do this.
Nah, everything's gonna be fine. Don't worry. Just remember to keep your answers short. People who have something to hide always talk too much.
Hi, folks.
Hi.
Did you have a good time in Canada?
Oh, great.
Canada, wow.
What was the purpose of your trip to Canada, sir?
Fun.
Well, please check out.
Well, I think we're all strictly on the up and up.
Miss, you've been very quiet. Is there something I should know here? You seem awfully nervous. May I have your name, please?
All right. I guess I should have known better than to try this.
No. Dad, don't. It was just a mistake.
You men just want to back off? What does he want to say, sir?
We were trying to put one over on you. Eddie! We don't have a rabies certificate for the dog.
See, you got a badge there.
Oh, yeah.
You a policeman?
Retired. 30 years on the Seattle Police Force. Me, of all people, should know better, huh?
Absolutely.
Definitely.
Sure.
Next time, remember the rabies certificate. Have a safe trip home.
Thanks, officer.
Thank you.